Hello, Reformers, and welcome back to WARTILE. WARTILE has obviously just entered early access on Steam, and I have been given, by the developers, a couple of keys to give away. And if you'd like one of those keys, then just comment in the comments section below, and maybe visit their page, add it to the wish list or something along those lines, you know, whatever you'd like to do. And, you know, then I'll, at a later date, probably in about a week or so, I'll pick out a couple of winners, and then I'll send you the keys, or I'll send you a message, or I'll reply to your comment and tell you to send me a message, dependent on, you know, the things on YouTube, because sometimes people have private messages disabled and stuff like that. But anyway, there you go. That's a bit of a giveaway there for you. And we are now a little bit more advanced in the game. I have played some missions off screen, but one of the missions I actually wanted to show because it actually highlights a couple of, shall we say, more advanced mechanics. And then maybe we could do the new mission after that, but it depends, because this mission took quite a while, I think. And I've also unlocked a new unit. Now this unit is the Brute, I believe, and he is absolutely insane as far as I can tell. He does so much damage, so we're going to be buying him. And, oh yeah, I should also mention that whenever units kill something in battle, they gain experience, and you can't actually tell what kind of experience that is. I don't think you can actually see how close they are to a next level, but that increases the amount of runes they can use. So, for example, I'm going to give this guy an attack skill token. But if we actually take a look here, they also have three different skills. He obviously only has one unlocked at the moment, which is Force Attack. They also have a number of equipment that you can use. Obviously, I don't have any equipment with this guy at the moment, so there's no point in doing that. But if I go over to this guy, now as you can see, this guy is probably one of my favorite characters just because he's a bit more unique than the standard, you know, I'm just going to stand here with a shield and bash away things. He has four token slots, which is really nice. So as he continues to level up, I can only assume that you can get more and more tokens, and you can have double tokens. If I wanted to, I could have every single slot filled with attack skill, and that would increase our ability to hit the enemy, which is really nice. Now obviously, if I go over here, and we can actually start to see some of the equipment. Obviously, this is still early access, so you know, this is still being fleshed out, but this is a very nice weapon that we have right here, as far as I'm aware. As you can see, this is a 2. This is a 2-dot weapon. Now, I'm not entirely sure if that just means it's a tier 2 weapon, that means it's better, or whatever, but I do know that this fellow over here is using... Wait a minute, where is he? Can I not see him? There we go. Okay, so as you can see, this guy actually has a helm on. Now, the helm is actually the skull of hell that we gained in the mission where it didn't appear, and there was obviously a good reason for that, because again, there was a bug, and they fixed the bug. The developers fixed it right after, which is really, really good. So, very fast of them to do that. Also, he has three skills that he can use here. So, Dirty Kick to the Groin, giving 5 damage and -1 movement range for 10 seconds. That's actually really nice. I like Shield Push a little bit more than that, but yeah, anyway. He has also leveled up, so we can go for an additional point in something. We are going to be giving him, I think maybe some health would be nice. So, let's give him a little bit of health. A little bit of extra health there, and yeah, as you can see, he also has a number of weapons that he can choose from. I think he's actually using the best thing for him. I'm actually unsure about what these stats mean at the moment, so actually, wait a minute, we can actually just see on there, can't we? Okay, so this is, I think this is maybe better than what we're using. No, it's, yeah, it is. It is better than what we're using. Oh, fantastic. Okay, so yeah, it seems like it does show you the difference in the weapons. So my bad. The shields also do show you. We're using the best shield for us right now, so that's nice. Okay, I didn't realize that before, so yeah, I'm continuing to learn things. And what about this? That gives him a little bit more, that gives him a little bit more defense. Let's just use the better damage one. And obviously our spearman has nothing. He does have another helm as well as this, which is mend wounds. It's pretty amazing that he's got his own self-healing ability, so I quite like that. Anyway, what we're going to be doing now is we're going to be partaking in the mission that I've already completed, but it's something that I think is actually pretty cool because it highlights most of the really nice mechanics that you'll be finding in WARTILE. And if you're obviously already not very, so shall we say, a fan of this kind of game, then obviously you probably won't be. But I think this is really a really cool game that you need to sort of give a chance to. So we're going to be using one defensive unit, one sort of, shall we say, offensive unit. He's probably going to be really offensive. And this guy, who is much more of a utility unit. So we're going to try that, you know, try that a bit. The other guy at the back there, I actually used him for this. So, yeah, last time. So I'm not entirely sure if we're actually going to do very well, but let's try, shall we? Let's just try with these. I actually cancelled the mission, hilariously enough. Okay, so yeah, let's do that. There we go. Okay, and begin. All right, so we're going into the snowy lands of the Hydrun clan, and they have a number of war rings. Now, these war rings are things that we want to steal from them. We want to dishonor their clan. So that's what we're going to try and do. Now, we also have to search the deep caves and steal the voice of the gods, which is our main objective. So we're going to try and do that. So obviously, we're just going to start moving up here. Now, there are a number of different ways to go in this map, which I very much appreciate. So as you can see here, these guys have archers. Yeah, they have ranged units. So if I wanted to, I could go straight up here and start attacking these guys and, you know, just go, you know, fully, you know, full ham, basically, on them. But I don't really want to do that right now. I want to be a little bit more strategic about things. So we're just going to pick up a little bit of gold, because you never know when you may unlock your next unit. And we're also then going to go into this cave system here. Now, obviously, we are going to be attacked pretty much immediately, which is kind of annoying. But that's fine, because do you see these right here? These lost Norse units are a result of the helm, or the skull of hell, that we're currently wearing. And that is pretty amazing, in my opinion, because those units can be used as kind of, shall we say, fodder a little bit, but they can also be used as flanking units. So it's really quite cool for them to add something like that in, especially considering it's something that doesn't just affect your stats by a passive amount. It actually affects gameplay in a significant way, so I'm very much appreciating that. I have yet to come across any other items like that, of course, but obviously it's early days. And we're going to go over here now. Now, this is a bit of a problem. This gave me a problem beforehand, so we're going to just see how this goes. Obviously, this guy has a spear as well, so he is obviously capable of attacking us from quite far distance, so we're just going to be moving back. Yeah, I know, moving back. It's a foreign concept to me, isn't it? Yes. And we're going to be moving back, and we're going to try and kill him from here. Now, obviously, this guy is... I'm probably going to try and move him back a little bit more, just so that we can draw him in. I'm going to try and draw him in as much as possible. Let's try and move in there. There we go. And now we're going to move around here. And yeah, this is a bit of an issue, isn't it? Now, this guy is obviously going to do quite a bit of... Ah, there we go. Ooh. Okay. So now this guy, the two-handed weapon guy, does so much damage. So much damage. As long as he's able to hit. If he's able to hit, then obviously that does much more damage. So yeah, I'm going to see if we can just... what should I... Oh, no, never mind. Don't need to do anything. Okay, I was actually going to use force attack, because that goes right through enemy defenses, and it deals 30 pure damage, which I assume just ignores defensive bonuses. So we're just going to heal that guy, because he does need it a bit. And let's draw the others out. Obviously, there's an archer there that's being a bit annoying, but I'm going to draw the other one out here, and hopefully he's going to come in this direction, and we'll be able to deal with him. Yes, there we go. He's probably going to try and attack our berserker, because he is using a spear. Yeah, he is trying to do that. That's very annoying of him, isn't it? But it's okay, because we do, I think, have a bit of an advantage, because he doesn't have a shield. Ooh, now he's flanking himself. Yeah, there's also a mechanic in the game where if you attack a unit from behind, that is flanking, and that gives you a pretty big attack damage bonus. So I'm going to hope that we'll be able to make good use of that. Now, obviously, we're just going to rush these guys immediately, because they are archers. So we want to kill them as quickly as possible. We don't want them dealing too much damage to us. I'm just going to go around the other side here just to cut him off, if I can. Doesn't really matter, though, because the spearman is really, really good at that as well. So there you go. We picked up one of the rings already, And we can now make our way out of the caves. Is there anything else here that I missed? No, I don't think so. Sometimes there are chests in these caves, so we need to make a little bit of a lookout for those. Alright, so we're spawning right next to one of these towers. I was going to try and send my berserker up there, but it seems like he's gotten stuck, so never mind. We'll just send the spearman, and maybe the berserker can join him. No, it seems like the berserker can't join him, so it's okay, because the spearman is much higher level and much easier to control up there. And as you can see, these are control points. Now, these control points, they give you godly power, which is what we... Well, technically, they are battle points now. It seems like they have changed the name of those, but they're battle points. Battle points obviously used to cast spells and to use various equipment. So that's pretty nice. That is pretty nice. So yeah, otherwise, as you can see here, this is one of our objectives. The Hydran clan are proud warriors. Steal 4 war rings from them. I think this is... Is it an optional objective? I don't think it's optional, actually, but it's kind of nice to know whether it is or not. And this is a waypoint. Now, what they've done is they seem to have added a bunch of extra waypoints. Maybe it's just me, but obviously this is a very long mission, and we have 24 battle points right now. It's really quite insane, so I think we'll be absolutely fine here. Now, obviously there's another cave up here, and there's another one over there. I'm actually unsure where to go. I think we probably want to go in the back entrance. I think that would make the most sense. So let's head in here. Yeah, as you can see, look at these guys. They're just ready for us, aren't they? But what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to try and take our people around the side here. I'm actually going to use this against this guy. Yeah, look at that. It goes right through his defense. And I'm hopeful that we'll be able to maybe just eliminate the archers as quickly as possible. Because they are pretty annoying, especially for people without shields. I don't think they can actually block them very well. So we're just going to heal the berserker there. And hopefully he's going to get killed. Come on now, kill him. Come on now. We are flanking him after all. There we go. We gained a helm. Another helm for our troubles. So we'll be able to equip our berserker with a helm, hopefully. I'm actually unsure whether he's able to wear that, because he has light armor. So I don't know whether he has a restriction or anything. There's another one of the rings. And there's also this now. Yeah, so this is where we would have actually come in otherwise. We would have come in over here. So we would have just fought those two guys, and then we would have come up this way. But I'm actually unsure which is the best one to go for, but I'm pretty happy with just going from behind here, so it's all good. And we're just going to get ready for our berserker to chop down the barricade. Yes, there we go. That's pretty nice. And we can now make our way down here. Yes, kill it. Kill the wood. He has done nothing to you but kill him. There we go. Okay, so otherwise, we can now just make our way here and flank him. Yes, there we go. Let's flank that guy as well. Oh, do you see that damage? That damage. I've never used the berserker before, by the way. That's why I'm looking at him and thinking to myself, wow, what did I ever do without him? Yeah, what did I ever do without him? Anyway, let's see if I can actually just get a bit of a flanking maneuver on him. Yeah, I don't think I'm actually going to be able to get a flank on him, so maybe I could just move him away. There you go. See, so if you use the positioning of your units to try and get a flanking maneuver on most of the enemies, you'll kill things very, very quickly, which is obviously part of the difficulty with the game, because sometimes people don't allow you to do that. And sometimes even if you are flanking, it's going to be pretty difficult. So anyway, now we can make our way out. I think we've collected everything here. And I'm going to actually use Mend Wounds on this guy, because he has actually got a self-heal, so I'm not entirely sure why I forgot to use it, but it's probably because it's a new ability, and I haven't really gotten used to using that just yet. But yeah, as it stands, as you can see, there's only one tower down here, which we could go and kill those guys for the battle points. I think it might be an idea just to get them dead for the battle points. Maybe it would be an idea. And I probably don't want to send my spearman down there first, but he does have Mend Wounds, so I suppose it's not really a big deal. But I'm a bit worried about him dying, maybe. Am I a bit worried? Yeah, I think I might be a bit worried now. Yeah, I don't know whether it matters, though, because we've just killed another one, and there's one of our undead units. And is this guy... Yeah, he's got Mend Wounds back, so I'm just going to give him that. And then hopefully this guy can go up and kill the archers. There we go. Yes, kill the archer. And yeah, this guy has a limited amount of time on the battlefield, as far as I'm aware. So, yeah, whenever you get one of these, you've got to make the most of him. So, yeah, every time the skull gets a little bit smaller and smaller and smaller, and when it disappears, obviously that's when he's dead. So, yeah. It's kind of nice that they've added temporary units, though. I think that's a pretty cool mechanic. So, otherwise, I think we can make our way back up, and we've got some extra battle points. Extra experience as well, of course, for our Berserker. And then we'll make our way to the final batch of units. Now, I think there is actually a pretty difficult, shall we say, situation up here. I'm actually... Why am I taking my spearmen first? No one knows. No one knows except me, I guess. So, yeah, we'll just go up here and mend wounds a little bit more. Okay, so let's have a look here. So there is an archer up there, and there's a bunch of barricades. There's two spearmen, so obviously the spearmen are going to be pretty annoying. Oh, this is a bit different. This is different than what I did beforehand. I think this is different. It looks different, at least. Maybe it's just me. But, yeah, it looks a little bit different than what I did beforehand. So let's move forward. Oh, wait, can I move in here? Oh, yeah, I can. Never mind. That's it. Oh, there's a chest. I missed the chest. There you go. There are actually some pretty hidden chests. Okay, so now we can make our way up. I just got to be really careful to make sure that I heal my forces within good time. I think I'm probably just going to heal the Berserker now because I don't really want him dying. I think that would be a pretty bad thing. So let's just get that dead, and I'm going to move this guy around. And we're just going to kill... we're just going to kill these guys first, because the archer is not really doing too much right now. Or he kind of is, isn't he? Oh, well, never mind. We killed him. So that's fine. And I think I'm just going to let the Berserker deal with this. It seems like the Berserker is probably going to be my favorite unit from now on, because he is just... Like, when he hits, he does so much damage. It's not even funny. Like, really? Is he going to kill him? Yep, there we go. Two hits and he's dead. Actually, no. He's left with 1% HP, but still. There you go. Nice. And we've got some extra battle points there as well. Now we can go back down and lower the drawbridge, which will then take us to a spearman, a shield user, and another archer. That's pretty fine. That's okay. I think I should probably heal my main tank there. Let's use the lever, and then we'll make our way over the bridge. There we go. Okay, so this guy can go here, this guy can go here, there we go. I found that rushing the enemy is actually a much better way of playing than being more cautious, I guess. Because it seems like they're not prepared to be, like, beset upon by huge amounts of units instantly, so it kind of makes things a little bit easier. But obviously, these are not human players, so you would think that they would be prepared, but... For the most part, they're not, so I don't even know, but yeah. Now, this is another mechanic that they're introducing here, the key mechanic. Now, this lever requires a key, and we're going to obviously be entering here and taking out these guys. Now, obviously, this is... where's the archer? I don't think there is an archer here, so I don't think I really need to worry about him, but yeah, never mind. Okay, so let's just make our way over, and I think I'm actually just going to use my fierce attack against this guy, get him out the way as quickly as possible if I can, heal that one as well. But yeah, we're doing a pretty reasonable job with our battle points here. I don't even know. I guess that's the key, really. Yeah, speaking of a key, there's the bridge key. Fantastic. So I've picked that up now as well. But yeah, I think that is the key with the game. I think you really do have to manage your battle points relatively well. Now, these guys are actually taking quite a bit of time to kill. So, yeah, I think that's mainly just because I didn't really flank them that much, but obviously I still have 20 battle points, so still 4 heals available, which is just insane, so that's nice. But is there any... Nope, there aren't any treasure chests in here, so I don't really need to worry. And now we can head outside. There we go. All right, so now we can use this. The drawbridge comes down, and there's obviously an archer on the other side, which this is where we're going to be a bit cautious, because we want this guy to come down to us. Or do we? Well, that's the thing. I'm just going to go over here and kill the archer, or at least my spearman is going to pursue him as much as possible. Seems the spearman's a really good chaser as well, by the way, because his other ability, Immobilize, obviously stops people from moving, and that's actually really, really nice. So, what is this guy going to do? Is he just going to stand there? Yep, he's just going to stand there and get flanked. I'm going to shield push him, actually. I'm going to shield push him all the way back there. And he's going to then tank my undead unit a little bit, and hopefully we'll be able to finish him off from there. Maybe we're able to finish him off a little bit. As you can see, as soon as you get hit with the Skull of Hell on, it summons one of those undead units. It has a chance to summon it anyway. So let's go up there. And there you go. With the war horn in your hand, your call to battle will echo among the gods. And there you go. So that's it. That is the level. And there's a bit of an extra look at WARTILE. I'm actually really enjoying the game, and it's quite amazing because you initially look at it and you kind of think, I don't think I'm going to enjoy that very much. But when you start playing, you kind of think to yourself, wow, it's actually very well done for an early access title. I mean, literally, it's only just come out in early access, and they've already released two patches that have fixed a majority of the bugs, in my opinion. And I suppose the only thing that is left to do is just continue fixing those bugs and obviously to add extra content. I actually have no idea how much extra content there is. I do know that there's a mission over here, and there's also multiplayer, so you can also play multiplayer with your friends if you so desire. And there's a deck manager as well, which you can obviously change the various things that you want to take in, so you can, yeah, you can do all this. I haven't actually done anything like this because I personally love heal unit, but yeah, drag to friendly unit, increase the defense and attack skill of friendly units in an area for a limited time. You can do all of this if you so desire. I don't personally think that I would like to do this right now, because heal unit, in my opinion, is probably the best. But I think lightning could be used. Lightning is actually a pretty nice ability, because that will maybe eliminate one of the stronger units. So that's nice. But otherwise, there you go. I thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time.